Not for nothing is Pandurang Pakhale called the Iron Man of the Maharashtra Forest Department. Posted at the Pinch Tiger Reserve as a range forest officer, he has risked his life consistently and has been responsible for the arrest of over a dozen hardcore tiger poachers. He was strongly opposed by influential people who were in league with poaching syndicates. Undaunted, he continued to investigate leads and built a network of informers who helped him hone in on culprits living near the tiger reserve and their handlers whose tentacles ran deeper across the country. Strong protests were organized and false police complaints filed. When threats came his way, it became clear that a ruthless mafia was at work. He reacted by redoubling his raids and arrests. In January 2017, he went after pangolin traders who he took to court. When big money pressures mounted, he arrested still more links in the chain, which saw a monitor lizard poaching network of 8 poachers working in the tiger reserve being arrested in June 2017. Is a Nagpur-based lawyer. His knowledge and application of the provisions of the Wildlife Protection Act 1972 have won us incredible precedents. He is not just good at putting poachers and wildlife traders behind bars, he's good at keeping them there. Running a commercial law practice in Nagpur, he readily fights cases pro bono for NGOs and often appears as a special counsel for the Maharashtra and Madhya Pradesh state forest departments. He has won an impressive number of convictions, including the cancellation of bail for Chacha, the notorious tiger skin trader whose crimes rival those of the late Sansar Chand. A man of integrity and intelligence, his grit and determination is taking down wildlife criminals one court case at a time. To present the awards to these two exceptional men working for the wildlife of Maharashtra, may I request Mr. Parveen Pradeshi, additional Chief Secretary Maharashtra in the office of the Chief Minister and a previous Sanctuary Wildlife awardee himself, to please come on stage. Ladies and gentlemen, our Sanctuary Wildlife Service Award goes to Kartik Shukul, and a special Sanctuary Tiger Award goes out to Pandurang Pakhale.
Positive if we radically reform our delivery system, the Forest Service of India, and amend dangerous laws and strengthen the process that protects our amazing national bird. Without this, the tiger in India has no hope in hell. Lines by one of my favorite authors and the gentleman sitting in the front row here, Mr. Valmik Thapar. Even though we've never met, he has a very big role to play in my presence before you today. His books, his documentaries are responsible in a very large way to motivate me to do what I'm doing today. But the list of people who are responsible for my presence here today would not be complete without the following. My parents. If it were not for him, I would have not gone to the jungle at an early age, and I would have not fallen in love with the same level of passion that I have today. My family, my brother, my sister, my uncle, all of them are present here today, who not only motivate me, but they also instill a sense of confidence that you can't get without the support of your family. I must also thank, very importantly, investigating officers and forest officers. One of them is present with me here today, Pandurang Pakhale. A spirit of time would restrict me to go into details regarding the great work that he has done. Suffice to say that his recognition today is reflective of that. Apart from him, there are many other unsung heroes, and it is in fact those who are on the field, those who do patrolling, that really protect the forest. My work is only incidental. So I must also thank every single person who is involved with prosecution of cases and with patrolling. I also must thank my juniors, and very specifically Rohan Joshi and Abhilash Srivas. Rohan, in fact, does help me only with my commercial practice, but Abhilash is somebody who fell in love with the jungle the first time I took him there. I took him to Bandhavgarh, and the first thing he said was that once we are back in the court, I want to start working with your wildlife cases. And he has this sense of passion about wildlife, which is very rare in lawyers today. I must also thank my father-in-law. I started practicing with him at a very early age. In fact, I was an intern only in my first year. And I think his contribution into shaping me what I am today is immense. Lastly, I must most importantly thank somebody who supported this and somebody who believed in me when everyone else was saying that what you're doing is wrong. My wife. this list would not be complete without attributing at least some sense of without attributing at least some sense of gratitude to the judiciary. Till 2014 December, there were absolutely no cases in the context of bail related to the Wildlife Protection Act. The judiciary stepped in and radically changed the way bail is granted. And I'm happy to tell you, in some of my matters, we've kept poachers behind bars for as long as 3 to 4 years. In fact, the one case where we've kept them inside the jail for longest was my first case. 2013 was the first time I was appointed as a special public prosecutor for the state of Maharashtra. And even today, those poachers who were responsible for poaching of 3 tigers in that case, even today they are behind bars. Lastly, someone who's been supporting me for a very long time. Mr. Bittu Sehgal is right there. He supports me in the background in ways that a lot of people can't understand. Whenever I'm at that edge, when I lose hope, when I think that this case is not going to work, I call him. And we don't talk about law. He only does exceptional work of motivating me. I started with one of my favorite authors, and I will end with another. This is Billy Arjun Singh in an interview that he did with Bittu. And he concluded with these lines, and I truly believe them, to the point that I'm getting them tattooed on my back. The air we breathe and the water we drink stem from the biodiversity of the universal environment and its economics. The tiger is at the center of this truth. If it goes, we go. Thank you so much.
Ladies and gentlemen, a very good evening. It's a pleasure to receive Tiger Sanctuary Special Tiger Award 2017 I humbly submit that whatever I could achieve, it was because of teamwork. I alone can do nothing. My tiger poaching case was a result of a perfect blending of a teamwork. We used to plan in which direction our case has to be done, has to be. Our target is conviction. Unless and until we convict all the culprits, all the poachers, I will not, and my team will not be stopping. And the real, our target, real target is conviction of those poachers. At this juncture, I recall all the noble souls who helped me, strengthened me, and motivated me for carrying out anti-poaching activities. In Penge, this is my first range forest officer posting. I am looking after buffer range which protects the core part. I am dealing with 24 buffer villages and catering their needs, working together with them for conservation of wildlife. While dealing with all the poachers, what I got to know that they were belong to one school. They were getting taught in one school, that is ashram school in one of my village. So poaching is one part. After doing poaching, we go to court. But prior to poaching, what I am trying to do is that what Bittu sir is doing with Kids for Tiger, I am going for every event, just like Wildlife Week celebration, then World Environment Day celebration. I am going to students and I am getting them let know that what they are doing, how they should conserve the forest, and while doing that, in which school I was focusing, I came to know that most of my poachers belong to that school only. So whatever I was doing since the first day I joined my range, so that after knowing all the feedback from the poachers, that I was doing the right thing. So I will be very successful, or my department will be very successful in stopping those children before they become poachers. Whenever I used to ask them that if they have a pola, I am posted in a remote area of Gond tribal people, and I am dealing with them. So there are two more important festivals. One of them is pola, what we call, and the another is Holi. So I used to ask the children who are in standard 6 or 7 what they are doing, what they will be doing, or when they will be going to the what they are doing in vacations, so what they will eat. Most of the hands will come and they will say that they will eat sambar deer, meat of sambar deer. So such was the thing. Now the hands are coming down, and that will be the greatest achievement as a range forest officer. And last but not least, I thank every individual in my team, right from informers, right from the people who translate the Gondi language, and let me understand that what the people are doing, what the poachers are doing. I also thank you, Kartik sir. I also thank all the staff who are working with me. Even I am very thankful to the forensic lab, media, print media, electronic media, civil societies. Even for conviction, what we need is an independent witnesses. Otherwise, we can't get the conviction. So there is a very good civil society called Satpura Foundation, and the head is Kishore Rete sir. Constantly, I am very proud to tell and share on this dais that his two volunteers always for they were with me for 24 hours to do the panchanama, and they will be independent witnesses. Most of the cases, if I am not wrong, Kartik sir, fail because there are no independent witnesses, and in forest we can't get that. Okay, so I thank every individual who supported me. I thank Bittu sir who spotlighted me and who brought me from remotest part of the Maharashtra to this capital, state capital, economic capital of India. Thank you so much. Last but not least, I am very thankful to my parents, my wife Indira, and my pretty daughter Jnaneshwari. Thank you so much.
Give a round of applause.